my name's Corrina Hewat, and we're going to be doing the tune Drops of Brandy. Now, Drops of Brandy is in the key of A, but it has G naturals. So the scale that you're going to be playing in is... So, the tune starts. I'll just play the tune for you once through. Faster tunes is splitting them. Remember always to go back and listen to the beginning of the webcast where you'll find the tuning presentation to make sure that your harp is completely in tune. So we're going to start with the first phrase. It starts E, D, C, and your left hand is on the chord of A. So it's A, E, and A. And you'll see that the tune is split between the right hand and the left hand. So we're going to go. With the right hand. Do that again. And your left hand will play. So these parts in themselves are quite simple, but when you put them together, to relax your hands. You don't want to keep your hands in a tense position. You want them to be moving in between placing and pulling into your hand. So, the last phrase. Thank you. little bit by playing a kind of big bass A chord, like that. You can stretch it out so that you have not just the root and the fifth and the root, but the root, the fifth, and the third up above. Or you can make up any kind of actual chords. I don't mind actually. But at the moment we're just going to keep it simple and you feel free to adapt and elaborate as you want to. So, first half again, slightly faster. So it's okay. And watch how my hand is actually when I'm pulling in, I'm really pulling in my hands, my fingers, right into my palms. Okay. Try with your left hand to play an A chord. Stops at the top. Okay? Now you can play that with your thumb or you can also go like that if you like. Repeating fingers on the one string actually helps to build up speed. Rather than going, it's actually quicker to go like that. But that's up to you. So, the first phrase, second phrase, third phrase, and then we're going to finish with the fourth phrase is the same as the fourth phrase of the first half. So that's... So let's hear the whole of the second half of the right hand. Miss out that G and you actually don't have to worry about moving any levers. Just stay with the root, the fifth and the root. Or you can put the root, the fifth and the seventh in, which leads very nicely back into the A chord again. So let's try just root, fifth, root and then say a triad or a fifth on the top. Through those chords again, the A and then the F sharp. Just keep it really open. Arpeggio first. Okay. basic chords, the very basic tune. And as you learn to play the tune, you can then start to add some kind of decoration. I will be adding in a little bit of decoration here and there. Just little cuts. Try to change the fingering. It means that I can add in the decoration or not, depending on how I feel. Another nice decoration would be. So what we're doing is we're just playing a little E before the top A. Try that. You can add into this tune. So what we're going to do is try and play it all the way through with a basic left hand and a basic right hand, just to get the form of the tune and get it into your head. I find singing along really helps to remember the tune, so if you'd like to do that, please do. I won't at this point, but so the beginning of Drops of Brandy. Up here in the E, which you don't normally get in the F sharp chord if you were just to do a straight. So you could try adding in that E if you'd like. The D, as you can see, I'm just using the same A, the C sharp and the E, but I've actually got a D on the bass. And then, so that actually is using where my right hand is. What we're going to do is we're playing the bass. I'm just using the same notes as my right hand is using as well. This gives you the ideas for your own arranging of these tunes. So you could play harmony along with that on the F sharp. Whatever you like. So what we're going to do is play through the tune a few times and see if we can get it to lilt a little more. When you play it slowly, it seems very kind of ploddy, doesn't really have any swing to it. So we'll just take it up slightly in speed and see how it goes. Try playing around with your left hand. You don't have to play exactly what I'm playing, slightly faster. So the A chord, the F sharp, the G, and then in the E minor, I just moved all my fingers down one note each. So from there to there. Now make sure when you're playing these chords that you actually pull your fingers in and then get them back on the next chord and pull. If you play and stay stuck and move to the next chord, you'll end up having problems with your hands because you want your hand to place and pull back in, place, pull back in. It's the actual movement between the rigid placing and then the pulling back in, back out, back in. That has to be done to let your hand relax. Also make sure that your whole body, your shoulders are relaxed as well, just so that you're not creating any tension within your body, which you don't actually notice until afterwards when you start to get sore. So let's play this tune one more time and give it your best shot.